Hi everybody, Jasper Senior here. In this episode of Class Captures, I'm going to show you how to draw isolines. And this is related to our lab that we're working on, lab number 4. So before we start the drawing, let's go over just some basic rules. Just to remind you that the lines that you're going to draw never cross. They follow smooth parallel curves. And if you need to, you end them at the edge of the map. So this was the first diagram we were working on. It asked you to draw the lines in increments of 5. So I would recommend starting up in the upper left-hand corner at the 70s. So you connect them, making sure your line goes directly through both 70s. 70 minus 5 is 65. There's a couple 65s on there. And you weave your way through the 66 on one side and the 64 on the other side, remembering that contour lines always have higher values on one side and lower values on the other side. Here we have the 60 mark. There's a bunch of 60s. It's only right at the top that you need to weave your way through the 58 to the right and the 55 to the right and the 63 to the left. Then you have the 55s. Don't forget about the 55 at the top of the map. Then you've got the 50s, or the last line that you draw on this map. Now, remembering that the line goes through the number, so for example, 50, you got to go physically through the 50s, and you've got to weave your way through the other numbers, leaving higher numbers on one side and lower numbers on the other side. So let's take a look at the other example. This one's a little bit more complicated, going to require a little bit more dexterity with your finger or your stylus as you're drawing. So I would recommend starting near the island. It asks you to draw in 1,000 increments. So we'll start with the 1,000. And you need to weave your way through a couple close spots around there, but there's a couple thousands to make sure. Anything less than 1,000 is closer to the shoreline. And then the 2,000 kind of follows a similar path around and captures some of the 1,500 values, making sure to leave anything over 2,000 outside of the circle that you're, or the line you're drawing. This is the 3,000. You see at the top in the left side of the map, it actually ends at the edge of the map, and this is where you're starting to really get into the habit of ending the line at the edge of the map. And then you've got the 4,000s. 4,000 ends at a couple other spots on the map too, because we're getting a little farther away from the island. And then the 5,000s you finish up. Those are only in the lower right-hand corner. So I hope you learned a little bit and you can follow through your drawings with this on your lab. And for more videos, check out ensemble.lyric.org/fox. Thanks for watching.